All right, what's up, guys? Welcome to FIFA 18 Career Mode. I apologize for delaying this part. This is part number 24. I actually did just record, but my recording just cut out for no reason. I recorded like I haven't started the game yet, even, but I just recorded my intro. I'll show you guys the team that we went with. This is it right here. I went for two up front. Schneiderlin's gone up to 85. Vlasic has gone up to 71. A couple of players are a little bit tired. If we win this game, we go into the top four. So this is a huge game. Our manager rating went down to 68 after we got knocked out of the Europa League. So let's make sure that we don't get sacked like Ronald Koeman did in real life. We want to avoid that. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. Ronald Koeman in real life has been sacked by Everton Football Club. Kind of mixed feelings about it because I do like Ronald Koeman. I really do. But it just didn't work out with us. I think he's a great manager, but it just didn't work out with Everton for whatever reason. He didn't click with us. I don't think he loves the club, you know. And with when you're playing with Everton, when you're with Everton, you need to be have someone like now Unsworth in charge who knows the club, who loves the club, and who would do anything for the club. You know, like the Tim Cahills of the world or something. And I think that's why Moyes worked so well with us. He just knew the club. Even without any money or anything, he understood the club. He loved the club. Come on. Okay, we need to make sure that we don't concede early here against Man City.
At the front end of the team.
But Everton are playing Chelsea tonight. David Unsworth is going to be taking charge of Everton part time. Wouldn't mind if he got it full time, honestly. Consider our. Damn it, that was a bad challenge.
The referee, just the free kick.
If we once we see how he does for the. Few games that he gets. If he does well, I wouldn't mind seeing him get the job full time. I really do love Rhino. He's a bit of a legend. But we'll see.
It does.
There's quite a few names being touted for the job. Thomas Tuchel. I don't know if I'm even saying his name.
That's great.
We got Sean Dyche, who I really don't want to be the next Everton manager. If he's the next Everton manager, I'll honestly be really pissed off. Like, oh, genuinely good tackle. Oh, what a pass to Olivier Giroud. What a save. I should have went in a little bit more, probably. Oh, he kept that in. Scumbag.
Well, he has good chance there.
But yeah, I really don't want him to be the manager. And then you got the likes of Marco Silva being rumored, which would be good. I think he's a good manager. I honestly think, I don't know, I just feel like right now, for Everton, what we need is like someone who knows and loves the club, you know?
Schneiderlin.
Oh, and there's that man, Ross Barkley, with a beautiful pass. And speaking of Ross Barkley, there's talk of him going to be Rhino. Unsworth said that he definitely wants Ross Barkley to say, and he thinks he could become an Everton legend. So that's good news for me because I'm a huge Ross Barkley fan. And I would absolutely love him to stay as well. So it's good to hear that David Unsworth wants him to stay and is going to try and get him to sign a new contract. He said himself, and it's one at the Man City. Talking too much about Ross Barkley and not focusing on the game enough. And we're down to Man City within the first 20 minutes. Gabriel, Jesus. God damn it.
He took a chance to get in there, and the ball just
good first time goal, you know.
Couldn't miss from there.
No, he couldn't. Point blank effort, but you have got to be in the positions, haven't you?
We have more of an attacking formation today, so hopefully that doesn't backfire on us.
We could be in. It goes out wide again. Put into the middle.
What a goal! No, Timo Werner with an absolute screamer. Guys, this man just scores screamers for fun. Every goal he scores is unbelievable. It truly is. What a goal! What a cross from Barkley here. Dips it around him and look at that. No, what a goal, lads.
Well, once he got his foot
oh, lads, look at that angle right there. It's just absolutely sensational.
Yeah, he really did get a good connection with it, didn't he? And,
Pep can't believe it. And we're back on level terms through Timo Werner.
So, away we go.
What a goal, lads. What a goal.
Great chance.
God damn it, dude. Are you kidding me? Coleman, like, stepped away from him there instead of going into tackling. And Jesus scores again.
They've been the better side. They've played with great panache up to this point.
God damn it, dude.
Really sums up the
this is bad defending. There's a good tackle here from, who was that, Jagielka. And then look at Coleman. He steps away. He takes a step back instead of going in. I wasn't even controlling him. Should be going in there, lads. Come on.
Looking good, this move.
Can he do it again? Oh!
Plenty of power, but not too much direction.
Nearly.
Nearly. Quite contrary. It wasn't actually that close.
And that's a turnover to the opposition.
What the hell? What the hell just happened? Alright, it's halftime. I don't know what the hell just happened there, but it's halftime. And we're losing 2-1, which would be really bad for us because we need a top 4 finish. And Man City are 1 point ahead of us. They would go 4 points clear of us if they beat us here. We need at least a draw, dude. At least a draw. It would be absolutely desperation if we lost this. Desperation mode. Okay, what should we do? Should we make a change here at halftime? Bring on Bolasi for Vlasic, screw it. I might bring on Morales for Barkley, or Klaassen for Barkley maybe, or Rooney for Barkley in a little bit, because Barkley is tiring. So yeah, in a little bit I might bring on Rooney for Barkley, or Davy Klaassen for Schneiderlin, or something like that. We'll see.
Aguero.
Oh my god, I thought that was in. I truly thought that was in. Oh no, come on. De Bruyne is coming on? As if I didn't have enough problems before this. Come on, bro. It's fucked up. How are you going to do that to me, Pep? I'm going to bring on Davy Klaassen. And I'm going to bring him on for Ross Barkley. And I'm going to bring on Wayne Rooney. But I'm going to put him up front instead of Giroud. Because Giroud hasn't had the best game in the world. We'll go with that. Should we put Klaassen out wide and Sigurdsson in the center? Yes. We'll do that.
There's good progress with this attack.
And Everton have got winning the shot. Finally. And Werner gets the double. Beautiful goal there. Timo Werner. Come on! This young man's class. I'm gonna tell you that. At the start, when I signed him and he wasn't doing too well at the start, and he was getting bullied off the ball all the time. I thought I'd made a mistake in signing him. But God, did he prove me wrong. This man's finishing is just unbelievable. Timo Werner, what a signing you've been, lad. I thought Giroud was still going to hold his place in the squad, but no. The amount of screamers. It said there that Werner scored 6 goals in the Premier League on him. I think he's probably scored about 10 overall, but I'm not joking. Every single one of them has been an absolute screamer. I'm pretty sure. Like, every one of them has just been a class goal. What a challenge. Schneiderlin. Oh, terrible challenge. All of my games in the last few parts have been, like, really high scoring, haven't they? I think there's been, like, one game recently that hasn't been high scoring, and that was, like, 1-0 to me against Burnley, I think.
Taking on the defenders. The shot's on.
Oh, I thought that was in for a second. Really, really good.
Oh.
Good save. Good save, Jordan Pickford. Get it out. How did you not clear that ball?
It's De Bruyne.
How is this not cleared yet, lads? I'd love to know how they still have the ball.
He's looking for the cross.
Goal, Klaassen! Counter is real. Come on.
A chance to break away now on the counter. Well, we're coming to the end of the game. 2-2 still.
For a hat-trick. No! I thought he was going
to
be through.
To their next game. Gylfi Sigurdsson. He's got his shot off now.
Go. No, you fool, Seamus. All right. It's a draw. We could have had one more chance there, but it's a draw. We don't lose any ground on them, at least. It was looking like we would there for a little bit, but Timo Werner comes up clutch in the big games, and he scored 2 beautiful goals tonight. The first one especially, probably my favorite goal of the season, I would say. Ross Barkley scored some screamers as well, but this is definitely one of my favorite goals of the season. He's an absolute beauty.
A couple of goals, he'll just be disappointed. It didn't earn his team the full 3 points.
It's crazy that Ross Barkley got Man of the Match, even though Timo Werner got 2 goals. Right? So the first goal from Gabriel, but let's have one more look at this goal from Timo Werner. Beautiful pass to Barkley. Barkley puts it in there, and Werner, just insane. Insanity. That goal is just insanity. I love that goal so much, dude. Let's have one look at this in orbit. Put slow-mo on. And hide this. Look at this. Boom. No, I love that goal way too much. Let's have one more look at this from the start here. Gylfi Sigurdsson finds Barkley. And Barkley Look at this for a ball, though, as well, the way he curls it around that defender. And this finish, though. That is too much. What a finish, lad. Unbelievable. I absolutely love that goal. That's my favorite goal of the season, for sure. Look at that. They had 15 shots and we only had 5 with 4 on target and we got a point out of it. That's crazy. That's awesome. Ross Barkley didn't even have man of the match. Oh, he did. Werner had a 9.4. Okay. Interesting. They had 57% possession as well. They dominated the match, apparently. It didn't really feel like they dominated the match, though, did it? It's okay, we're going to go with that for the training. And bottom, see Leicester what happens. With 35 points. Okay, everyone done reasonably well. Lookman especially. Tom Davies starting to do a lot better, too. Good man, Tom Davies, lad. Okay, we've got Stoke in the league now. And we need a win here, because look at that league table. If we don't catch Man City, we're not catching anyone, basically. We're 4 points behind Liverpool. There's only 7 games left. 4 points behind Liverpool. 1 point behind Man City. So Man City are the team we have to catch. Maybe Liverpool if they slip up. But I'm thinking that Man City is the team we have to catch. Okay. Let's do the press conference. We'll praise... I'm going to praise Ross Barkley. Praise Ross Barkley because he's been doing so freaking well. West Brom, Barry Wolves. Oh, the Merseyside Derby is after this. It's like 3 days after this. Jesus, good lord. Player of the Month announced, and it's Gylfi Sigurdsson. Looking good there, lads. Well done, Gylfi. Surprised it's not Ross Barkley, to be honest, but whatever. No big deal. Okay, let's go. Stoke City. Wait, why are we 4 points behind now? Oh, Man City won their game, guys. So we have to win our game if we want to stay in touch. Liverpool are on 56 now, so they drew their game. This is a must win now. This is a must win, because otherwise we're going to be 4 points back of the Champions League spots. Big game here. Okay, I'm going to rest Barkley. I'm going to start Davy Klaassen and Tom Davies there. And we're going to start Morales, Sigurdsson, and Vlasic. Looks good to me. Let's do it. And we're going to start Werner up front, of course, after his performance there against Man City. Right, away to Stoke. Never an easy game, but we need to come up clutch here. We need to come up with a victory. So we can only be 1 point back of Man City and 2 points back of Liverpool. With 6 games remaining. Go on, Vlasic. Show us what you're made of, lad. Immediately, Vlasic burning down this corner. Okay.
Man Biram Diouf starts. He was the man of the match last time. Got the Everton lineup for you. Phil Jagielka plays with Andreas Christensen as the centre backs. And today, it's just the one.
Oh my god, I thought that was in. That would have been a hell of a rebound goal. Jesus, I would have been pissed off with that. Okay, we need a win. If we score the first goal, we'll just hold on for dear life, right?
He's there for him, and he's played it to him. Klaassen, can they bring the visitors into this game the qualities that have made them the highest scoring team in the league to this point?
Go, Werner. Go, Werner, go. Don't upset the rhythm. God, should have been better there from Gylfi. Should have been better from you, Gylfi. I would have expected Ross Barkley to bury that. I would expect you to bury that too.
Chop out. Shaqiri. Jeff.
Save.
It's come off the goalkeeper, still in
clear
play.
The ball. Jesus Christ.
Good defending.
What a save. Gylfi Sigurdsson, lad. Our fucking Gylfi Sigurdsson, Jordan Pickford, I meant to say. Gylfi Sigurdsson's not in goal, is he? Giroud is 6'4". Good lord, what height is Calvert-Lewin? 6'1", okay, yeah, we'll bring on Giroud then. Calvert-Lewin's good in the air too, but Giroud's 6'4", come on, we need him up there. And, should we make any other changes? I think at halftime we'll leave it for now. We might bring on Bolasie for Vlasic. And maybe Wayne Rooney at some stage as well, if Gylfi Sigurdsson, we'll see. People have been begging me to play Wayne Rooney more, but...
Darren Fletcher.
Oh, fuck off.
To put them in front! Well, they've got their noses in front. right at the end here.
Well, the supporters are going absolutely
nuts. Oh, this is bad, guys. This is bad. We're going to be 5 points, or fucking 4 points trailing behind Man City. 5 points behind Liverpool, but we are playing Liverpool next.
Now it's a goal, and I don't think it'll be the last one they score today.
Still 1-0 here, with the time almost up. What about this impact?
Lovely ball from Giroud. In with a chance. Oh, it really could have been.
I thought that was in.
Bring them level.
Well, it looked easy, didn't it? He's close in there.
What? Ross Barkley buries that 9 out of 10 times. Like, are you shitting me? That would have given us a chance to even get a win, maybe. Because we would have scored immediately after them.
Another shot.
We need a goal. Get that up there, Jordan. Fuck that. That's such horseshit, dude. That was such a shit game, too, and a shit loss.
Case of back to the drawing board after a defeat like this?
I think they were positive.
Oh, fuck that. What is this? Oh yeah, this one. The Barkley one is the one that I can't believe. Like, right after their goal, look at this. Right after their goal, beautiful play here. Ross Barkley lets it go, and then yeah, if he buries that, it's at least a point. And we'd... Oh, God, that is depressing. That is depressing, lads. Truly depressing.
Stoke City 1, Everton 0. So what do those results
mean? So we have Liverpool next now, and at the top of the table remain Tottenham Hotspur. We're fucking well behind, aren't we? Transfer after for Leighton Baines. No thanks. But as you can see here, guys, we're now 4 points behind Man City. Same games played, 6 points or 6 games remaining. And then you look at Liverpool, who we are playing next. If we beat them, we're 2 points behind them. So we must beat Liverpool. We absolutely must beat Liverpool. That's just factual.
Bottom of the table,
we need to
beat
Liverpool
with 25 points. And then reading
God,
up the table,
Man United in ninth.
Bottom,
what the hell?
With 27.
Who's in last?
Third
Brighton.
Bottom, Huddersfield Town with 32 points.
All right, thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. We'll be back with more FIFA 18 in the very near future. Only 6 games to go, so it won't be long before the end of the first season. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.